nice shortcut. Well, nicely done, though. Not exactly an angel in life, were you?
Who, me? I had my moments.
Cool. Now, if you want a lesson on how really not to act, take notes from those Sabbat assholes. You're a big bad vampire. Yeah, great, congrats. Now keep it to yourself. You go roar and you beat your chest, and that's what you can expect.
Wait, I've still got that list of people from high school. Why not? We got a hit list? Or shit list?
It's the same reason you don't let humans see you feeding. It's why the wolf doesn't want the sheep to know he's there. It's also why you don't go juggling dumpsters or outrun the 815 from Sacramento. And it's why you didn't know any of this when you woke up this morning.
But I could be a superhero. Okay, I get it.
Keep our secret, and you make things easier on all of us. We're living in the age of cell phone cameras. Fuck-ups ain't tolerated.
Even in 04.
Makes sense enough, right? Well, it ain't a casual thing for a fledgling like you.
What do you mean? What could happen?
That party back there with the guy in the suit and the Magilla Gorilla? The assholes that put your sire to death? That's the Camarilla. They make a tidy business out of enforcing vampire laws like this one.
Camarilla? So they're like the vampire good guys?
Yeah. I'll tell you what I think some other time, maybe. I like to let people form their own opinions.
More like politicians. Alright, so what's next?
Alright, now don't worry, because I know the area a little. You know what? I'm glad we're in this situation, you and I. It illustrates a point. You gotta utilize your surroundings.
Okay. But what does that mean exactly?
You do what you gotta do. Theft, destruction of property, breaking and entering. These will be the least of your sins before the night's out.
Sure.
So look around here. We gotta get out the back there through that magnetically sealed door. There must be a key someplace.
I'll find it. Okay, the icon to the left indicates that you are in a combat area. Right, the gun there. Combat, anything goes. Masquerade, as you can see the icons on top. Respect the masquerade. You can go feeding on people in broad daylight or in a crowd of people, stuff like that. Or using your vampire abilities, because humans will freak and humans will... Yeah, basically, you don't want to alert the muggles. Elysium, vampire, neutral ground. No combat or disciplines are allowed except blood buff while lockpicking. What about the other discipline that increases your perception and wits? That's what it's called. In masquerade areas, breaking the masquerade can carry dire consequences, such as the unwanted attention of vampire hunters. After 5 masquerade violations, your game is over. Your current number of violations is displayed in the upper right-hand corner of your character sheet. Which you can see... here. So you can't see my mouse, I don't think, but yeah, I've got 5 masquerade points here. So, I'm good for now. My experience, unfortunately, is 0. Die, my darling! So, well, about my character's name. I can't look at myself, can I? She has decided to call herself Dark Child. Her name is originally Sarah, but since the prince there was calling her Child, or Childer, she's decided to, you know, since she's gained and starting a new life, or new undeath, what have you, she has decided to pick a new name for herself. So, since she's a child, she's a pretty dark child. As pretty much any vampire would be a rather dark child indeed. So, hence the name Dark Child. That's a safe? Oh. When you can read a note, you will see this use icon. Readable notes can be various items like clipboards, newspapers, and letters. Use key, and then after using it, press it again. Okay. Password is Chop Shop. Really? That's right. We can't. I'm not gonna be able to do this. Yeah. I don't know the stuff for this. But I guess it's to get into that computer there. Anything else to say? What, you giving up? Look around a little.
What?
Come on.
You giving up? Ah, look around a little. Come on.
Beg your pardon? Wow. Yeah, I am magical. Yeah, I'm not affecting stuff that way. Big guy can break the bottles. I love doing stuff like that. No use key there. Oh, lights. Interesting. Alright. When you can use a computer, you will see this use icon. Computers are often helpful in solving quests. They can hold information like emails and files, as well as control various electronic devices. Every computer will have a list of the menus and commands you can use. Interesting. Many menus and commands will be password protected. Hacking, a combination of wits and computer, which you have a rank in each of those, or two ranks in each of those, rather, is a feat that allows you to hack into password protected items. You'll be prompted to press Control C to attempt your hacking feat. If the value of your hacking feat is equal to or greater than the difficulty of the encryption, you will be successful. Stop using a computer, type quit, or use the escape key. I would then use the escape key. Brothers Downtown Garage. Now, can I read this stuff? Or can I open this stuff? No. So what'd it say? Chop Shop? Password is Chop Shop. I might need the password. Welcome, Jim. Home menu. Available menus are safe. Available commands are help or quit. What about help? Type list to get the available menus and commands. Menu names are listed in brackets. Type the name of a menu to switch to that menu. Command names are listed after menu names. Type the name of a command to run that command. Different menus have different available commands. So list, we only have safe and grid, so safe. A password is required to enter this subdirectory. Well, I could either enter the password Chop Shop, or I can hit Control C to use the hacking feat. Why don't we see the hacking feat in action then? And if I fail, you know, I can just enter the password. Skill 3, hacking attempt. No Chop Shot. So we didn't even need to read that letter, that thing at all. Which is stupid to have it sitting there in the first place, next to the computer. Entering menu. Press enter to continue. That's pretty awesome. Okay, so we've got available menus as home, unlock, and lock. I'm assuming home would bring us back. What if we type lock? Kind of curious if it says it's already locked. Safe door is locked. Okay. Unlock. And I think list just lists this again, yeah. Alright, home. So we can hit. We can type in quit, or we can escape. When you approach a container, you will see this use icon. Press the use key to open it. If it's locked, you can try to open it with a lockpick. Once open, your inventory appears on the left side of the screen. The container's contents are on the right. Chop Shop key. Key to the stairwell at the back of the Chop Shop. Automated access systems. Take.
There we go. Now take that keycard and head out the back. I'll meet you out in the alley there. I'm gonna check out things from topside.
Got it. Okay, so press the inventory key to access your inventory. Left and right arrow buttons above your inventory list to access different inventory categories. Keys are located in the equipment category on a key ring. Most keys once used will not be needed again and are removed. Some keys have magnetic locks and cannot be picked open. They must be opened with the appropriate key card. Like the one we just got. So inventory. So I still have this lockpick, so I don't use up a lockpick, I guess. Or maybe it'll break in certain cases. So where's the key card? Your key ring contains these rings, Chop Shop Key. Okay, so it's a key card, but it's just on a key ring. Okay. Good enough.
I'm waiting on you, Princess. To be honest, I ain't worried. You, however, ought to be.
Okay. So I think, is this where we want to use it? Yeah. And he's gone. Going into sneak. Oh boy. Look at Jack go. Oh, sweet. Awesome. You've been wounded by the Sabbat. This blue bar represents your current level of health. As you sustain regular damage, it will turn black. I'm guessing there's no way to avoid that in this case. It's part of showing you how things work. If your health is completely defeated, you will suffer final death and your game is over. Your health regenerates over time. When you are feeding, your health regenerates much faster. I'm not sure, but I think if your blood is empty, your health will not regenerate. If your health bar begins to turn yellow, it means you have sustained aggravated damage. Certain hazards like fire and supernatural attacks cause aggravated damage. This takes much longer to heal than regular damage. I guess that was electricity or something. So we can't even try to pick this lock. So I'm guessing I want to advance that way, but let me just see if anything's back here of interest. And the answer to that would be no. Oh, there he is.
Fucking waste of unlife, these Sabbat Vatos. You get winged?
Yep.
Hey, look at them potholes. Those will close up soon enough. Better feed, though. There's someone down the stairs here. It's not the freshest catch, but he'll do.
What's the difference? Blood's blood, right? Ask a Ventru. They would not agree.
Well, when it comes to feeding, it's quality blood you're looking for, not the quantity. Bums and lowlife don't pack the same punch that a healthy, well-bred human will. Juice bags with a pedigree, that's the good stuff. But you gotta take what you can get. You ever had a PhD kid? Ooh, that's good stuff.
If you say so. I can imagine, you know, if you feed on somebody who's basically has narcotics or something running through their veins, it's probably not the most nutritious for you.
Remember what I said, though. Don't kill them. At least not the innocent ones. You're a monster now. Make no mistake. One of the damned and the fallen. You need to hold on to every last shred of humanity you have.
Let's say I get a little overzealous. What happens then? Start losing humanity.
An innocent's an innocent. You kill one, Even a worthless bum, even by accident, and it's gonna cost you a piece of your own humanity. Bring you closer to that beast you got welling up inside you.
The beast? What exactly does that mean?
The beast? It's always there. It's waiting to take over. When it does, it's like a wild animal wearing your skin. Desperate, scared, reckless. He'll do anything to survive, and it's you that has to deal with the consequences.
So, I can't kill anyone? That seems a little, restricting. Well, you're still killing self-defense.
I said innocent humans. If some asshole levels a 12-gauge your way, you drain him, skin him, and bash in his skull. Self-preservation is a vital part of humanity, after all. My favorite part, in fact.
I think I follow.
The only way to fight the beast is to keep in touch with your humanity, and don't go hungry. It's a fine line.
Got it.
All right, now go feed. Careful, though. He's gonna drain fast.
Be back in a minute.
Go on. I'll be right here.
Always like to see if they have something extra to say. So he's gonna be over there. Feed on the bum at the bottom of the stairs. Okay, so it is a bum. Something I have not gotten into. And these are the hotkeys. Now, blood heal. Now, I'm not completely sure. Yeah, I don't. I do not need to feed on this guy at all. I'm actually not damaged anymore. And my blood is full, right? But what are you gonna do? We will not progress until we do it. So, what I want to do... basically, I'm mostly using keys 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So, thaumaturgy... blood purge... just remind myself. That's not what I meant to do. Blood purge. Enemies near your character become violently ill, vomiting blood. Projectile striking a victim. Okay, so it's blood strike. Blood strike I could see using maybe more often. Blood purge is a good defensive kind of thing. And then we got Auspex and Dominate Command. That's all I really have right now. So Blood Strike. Not completely sure what Blood Heal does. Look at that. Now, blood packs you can gather. Reading the menu, you can hold blood packs in your inventory. So, you won't need to feed on somebody. You'll have them in your inventory. But you only can carry up to a certain amount. Forget how many. 5 or something like that? So, I'm not going to... I don't even have the blood packs right now, so... Alright, so this one, I'm going to make Thaumaturgy... Blood Purge. And my Auspex I'll put in the middle, right? Because I have the... I'm using a tactical board, and it goes basically 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 along the top. So... and then 1, 2, 9, and 8 on the bottom. So I'm basically... Are these keys 6, 7, 8, 9, and 0, I'm guessing, but they're not. They don't have numbers next to them. But just in case it is, I want 6 to be. Dominate, command, which is all I have right now. And then 7 could be this blood heal. And I'm going to pause for a second. I'm going to write this stuff down. Okay, we're good. Try to open that? Oh, he's down there. Yeah. Remember, you want to avoid draining your victims. Draining innocent victims or humans will give you a penalty to your humanity. The lower your humanity, the closer you get to the beast. And if that happens, you begin to lose control of your character. This is known as frenzying and may result in a masquerade violation if you're around humans. Basically, you lose control of your character and basically watch your character, you know, jump on someone and begin feeding, maybe multiple someones. I'm not completely sure about that, so yeah, with disregard to whatever's or whoever's around you, so not a good thing. So I will really attempt to not kill him. He's another one. You can't see me at all. Again, he's in a trance, being drained by a vampire like that is supposed to feel like ecstasy.
Not quite as good, huh? Yeah, you can do worse. There's some rats down the way. You think I'm kidding? You can survive feeding on animals if you can stomach that kind of thing.
Yeah, the Nosferatu do. Worse than the bum's neck? That scarf tasted like old gym socks.
Now, give it a try.
I'll think about it. Rats can be fed upon to gain a single blood point. You'll find some rats at the other end of the alley near the yellow windows. Killing rats has no impact on your humanity score. Humans do not react well when they see live rats being sucked on. Yeah, I'm guessing not. Alright, now we get some furry rats over here. I don't know if I'm supposed to sneak up on them. Oh, I was already sneaking. Tasty. I don't need any blood points, but I'll use the practice, I guess. You don't even see it drain. You can't feed on them without killing them, apparently. You're done. Good thing you can't overload them. Blood. Oh, wrong button. I'm gonna do that for a while. Sorry, guys.
You rat sucker! Hey, I don't care what you do, but just so you know, polite vampire society looks down on that kind of thing.
Yeah, so the Ventru, they can't feed on the rats at all. So I guess if you were playing a Ventru, you'd skip this part, or he'd tell you not to eat the rats, and maybe you'd have an option to, you know, kill them anyway. But yeah, that was pretty nasty. And yeah, the Ventru, even if they feed on basically the bum downstairs, they'll end up puking. Or they have a chance to end up puking or something like that. They can be polite and pass me the salt for my rat.
Keep it down. Got someone around the way here.
Just one guy?
Not too much of a threat by himself, but you never know if there's more in shouting range. You're gonna have to sneak past.
Sneak where?
The building across from us with the garage door. There's some double doors on the far side. I'll meet you inside. Just Just stay low and stick to the shadows, and don't let him see you.
Alright, across from us with the garage door. Double doors. Okay, I'll do my best. See you in a minute.
Alright, go.
Gone. Sneaking is a combination of dexterity and stealth, a feat that allows you to move among your victims and enemies without being detected. You must be crouched to sneak. Blah, blah, blah. Right, here we go. The meter to the left indicates the proximity of your enemies and their chances of detecting you if they're looking that way. So I guess that's a percentage. 0% right now. Green means you're completely safe. Yellow means you might be seen. And red means they will see you if you look in your direction. An enemy's chance of detecting you is directly tied to your sneaking feat. If you are detected, your enemies will often say as much and come to investigate. Wondering how tough this is going to be.
Go on ahead, just keep it down.
Literally. Does anybody go through here? Oh yeah. Stick to the shadows. Got 11% chance to be seen. Oh, I can move this? Wait a second. Can I move this enough that I can... Percent is higher now. I don't know where this guy is. Oh, he's right there. Can I sneak around here? You've been detected by your enemy. Try again. Remember to crouch by pressing the crouch key. Use a route taking you through shadows and behind cover. Make closer to him then? I was trying with cover. I was trying to go around that way. I need a way for him to move. Should I wait until he moves that way again? Well, maybe he just happened to move that way right when I did. I think I can jump on those. So, he's not moving anymore. See, I went this way last time and he detected me. I have to move through the light there. Unless I'm going to advance close to him. Let me try again, I guess. Hmm. Apparently I was seen only momentarily. So what if I stick over here and get in here? That worked. These double doors? Good.
Keep it quiet. They're inside here. Seems that shovelhead outside just got separated from his pack. He's wounded too. Go take care of him. Don't worry. He's probably greener than you.
Okay. So I can actually take him though, even though I sneak past him. So what makes you think that?
The Sabbat, you see, they don't have the most rigorous training program. In fact, that poor sod is lucky if he knows he's a vampire.
How can that be?
He's probably just turned and beaten over the head. They like to do that, make shock troops, cannon fodder, put him out of his misery.
Sounds good. I've got a little frustration I need to work out.
He is a vampire, so be ready.
I'll keep that in mind. See ya.
Go get him.
I'm on it. To engage in unarmed combat, you need to equip your fist and attack. To equip your fist, press the melee weapons key, F1. Until the fist icon is highlighted in your melee weapon inventory, use fist and list, rather, and then click the left mouse button. Press the attack key. Initiates your attack. Yeah, I'm not that good at this. Unarmed combat fee is a combination of strength and brawl, which I have ranks in neither. Directly affects your success in unarmed combat. There are different attacks depending on what direction you are moving in when you initiate your attack. Try different combinations of moving and attacking in the upcoming battle. You can also block your enemy's attack by pressing and holding the attack mode key. To put your fists away, press the holster weapon key. Oh, okay, so it gave me a little shortcut. Okay. So that's holstering. So I can't attack him any other way? Can I use thaumaturgy or something like that? So yeah, you see the fist icon in the lower left? It means I already have it active. I don't feel very confident here.